Brooklyn.
Oh, none of my kinfolks, huh?
Uh-uh. And you can tell them that. All of them, including that niece of yours, Miss Laura Williams. Say, Aunt Ella, if you were to tell me where Laura was at, where would you tell me she was at?
I wouldn't tell you at all. For as far as I can make out, Laura ain't paying you no heed.
She don't take me much, huh? Where'd you get such an ugly old niece who wouldn't pay no heed to me? Who's the best bronchus in this year territory?
You are, Ben.
And the best bulldog in 17 counties? Me, that's who. And looky here, I'm pretty, ain't I?
Pretty as a picture.
Curly-headed, ain't I? And bow-legged from the saddle for God knows how long, ain't I?
But you stop taking the rock.
Well, what else does she want than the dad she knew?
I don't know, but I'm sure for certain it ain't you. What are you taking to the last social tonight?
And I ain't thought much about it.
I'll bet you come over to ask Lori.
What if I did?
You ain't to me, too? I'll wear my fascinator.
Yeah, you too.
Then I'll have the money hired to make
and we just point the horses home, I can picture the whole thing.
I can see the stars getting blurry, and I take you home in Missouri. Ride us slowly home in Missouri with a strange on top. I can feel the break in the weather, feel the sleepy head near my shoulder. I am broken close to my shoulder till it falls. Come up, the sun is swimming on the river or hill. Moon is taking a header, and just as I'm thinking, all the earth is still. Well, I'll wake up in the matter. Hush, you bird, my baby's sleeping. Maybe got a dream worth a keeping. Whoa, you teen, and just keep a creeping at a slow clip, clop. Don't you hurry with the Surrey with the fringe on the top.
Only, there ain't no such a ring. You just said you made the whole thing up.
Well. Folks coming down from Bushyhead, you know, for the box social.
Cousin made me notice your big wagon to bring them down from the station.
Yeah.
Of course I would, if you'd ask me.
Well, you know, we got to talk about a lot of other things. I'll go hitch your wagon up now if you say it's all right.
It's all right. Go ahead.
Thanks, Aunt Ella.
Hey, Aunt Ella, look what we brought you.
Hi, Will!
Hi, Aunt Ella.
How's it doing today? Did you do any good at the steer roping?
I did pretty good. I won it.
Good boy. Always knew you would.
Ain't nobody can sling a rope like that territory, boys.
But I can't stay but a minute, Aunt Ella. Gotta get over to Aunt Annie's house. Her pa said if I was worth $50, I could marry her.
$50? That what they give you for prize money?
That's what.
Name. If Annie's pa keeps his promise, we'll be damn finished with.
And if he don't, I'll take her right out from underneath his nose, and I won't give him that present that I brought for him. Excuse me, Aunt Ella. Come here, fellas. Look. You put it up with your eye like this, turn it just a bit to the right, and then the picture changes.
Whoa, Bob, he's psychic.
They call it the little one.
Silly skunk. The hubby? I'd be ashamed of herself. You too. I definitely see those pictures. Oh, wait a minute. I'll get it.
Oh, please don't, Annie Ellard. She wouldn't understand.
Oh, no telling what you've been up to. I bet you carried on plenty in Kansas City.
I wouldn't exactly call it carrying on, but I sure did see some things I never did see before. Mr. Skidmore, could you please move that rocker over there in that room?
Sure thing, Will.
You're just never going to believe the things I see. Going by the smell. Almost every time I took a walk, going over to Wayne Wayne's house. Got $50.
Good for you, Will.
Back early. Bye, Ann Miller.
Come on, fellas. Time to get going.
Down filthy sneak and Laura's got her cap set for her?
You.
I mean, besides that, you know, they gotta be plenty of other men trying to spark her.
Well, there's that fine pharmacy touches just inside old Ellis. Then that old widow man makes out he's a doctor or a veterinary or something.
That's right. Hello, Judd.
Hello yourself.
Well now, what about him? Laura wouldn't take up that bullet-colored growling man.
Now, don't you say nothing against Judd. He's the best hired hand I've ever had. Just about runs the place by himself. Well, two women couldn't do wrong. You ought to know that.
You'd let Laura take up with a man like that?
Why, you said she's tuck up with him?
Well, he lives here, don't he?
Out in the smokehouse.
Changed my mind about seeing the handout today. Leave until tomorrow. Got to quit early because I'm driving Laura over to the party tonight.
You're driving Laura? Wouldn't that just make you bald? Well, remember, Aunt Ella, me and you's got a date together. And if you pack up a nice box lunch, maybe I'll bid for it.
How you taking me, Curly, in that rig you made up? I ride still nothing like the rig of lightning bugs.
That ain't no made-up rig, you hear me? I hired it over to Clanmore.
Clan, you did?
Sure did. Bird one, too. Remember, Aunt Ella, when I come calling for you right after supper, be sure you've got your beauty spots fastened on your problem so you don't lose them off of here. That's right, it's my turn out. Oh, I'll see you before tonight anyways. I'm on my way back to the station. Laura, ma'am, ain't no finer rig. I'm thinking that I'd care to so up for that shiny little Surrey with the fringe.
Do. I know what's right, wrong, 'cause I've been tempted.
It's Persian.
You sure for certain you love him better than you love Liv?
Oh, I was sure. For she know that Will Parker start talking Persian and changing my mind back.
But Will wants to marry you.
Oh, so does Annie Hackham.
Did he ask you?
Oh, not directly. But how I know it is, he told me this morning when we was riding in his buggy that he wanted to ride like an elephant to the end of the world. Well, it can only go as far as Catoosie. Let us take us to sundown. Then we have to be all night together somewhere, and being all night together means he wants a wedding. Don't it?
Not to a peddler man, it don't.
All right. He ain't better than those folks. Gotta give you something just this
time.
Chippity cricket! How high you've grown up! Last time I come through here, you were short like a shrimp with freckles. Now look at you, a great big beautiful lady.
Quit biting me! If you ain't had no breakfast, go eat yourself a green apple!
Don't call me a dumb, I ain't Don't you go and be mad at me.
Ain't I said I give you a present?
Something to wear.
Well, I got things for wear. What hat? What is it?
Real silk, made of Persia.
Oh, they's awful pretty, and you don't have bows on to them at all?
That's right, Mom.
Hold up your foot.
Oh, you didn't have an idea I was going to let you snarl that garter up my name now, did you? No, everybody, come over here, Grandma, my petticoat.
Funny woman. Would be much worse if I tried to take your garters off.
Yeah, because they'd make your stockings fall down, wouldn't you?
Now, give me the other one.
What other one? Oh, you want to buy this one to match.
What do you mean, do I want to buy it?
I can let you have it for 50 cents. 2 bits.
Do you want me to get that baby to ram it down your windpipe?
All right. Doesn't anybody want to buy something? How about you, Miss Laurie? Must be wanting something, a pretty young girl like you.
Me? Of course I want something. I want a buckle made out of shiny silver to fasten onto my shoes. Want a dress made out of lace. Want perfume. Want to be pretty. Want to smell like honeysuckle vines.
Give her a cake of soap.
Want things I've heard of? And never had before. A rubber tire buggy, a cut-size sugar bowl. Want things not only to look at and hold in your hands, things to happen to you. Things so nice. If they ever did happen to you, your heart would quit beating, and you'd fall down dead.
I've got just the thing for you.
Oh!
Elixir of Egypt.
What's that?
A special formula developed by the pharaohs, John.
Smelling salts.
Oh, but there's a special kind of smelling salts. What it says on the label. Take a deep breath and you see everything clear. That's what the Pharaoh's daughter used to do when she had a hard problem to decide, like what dress she ought to wear to a party, or what prince she ought to marry, or whether she should cut off someone's head. She'd take a whiff of this.
Fiddlesticks. I'll take a bottle of that, Mr. Peddler Man.
Precious stuff.
How much?
2 bits.
Throwing away your money? Helps me decide what to do.
Yeah.
Now, Angela, don't you want me to show you some pretty doodads, you know, with lace around the bottom and ribbons running in it up?
You mean fancy drawers? Yeah.
Made in Paris.
Well, I never wear that kind myself, but I sure do like looking at them.
Yeah, these are all right, if you ain't going no place.
Well, bring your trinkets inside. Maybe I'll find something to eat and drink.
Oh, ask them, I don't you? Me and Laura have been having an argument.
About what, baby?
About what you meant when you said that about riding with me to the end of the world.
Well, I didn't really mean to the end of the world.
Well, how far did you want to go?
Oh, about as far as the Claremore, to the hotel.
Oh, what's in the hotel?
In front of the hotel is a veranda. Inside the hotel is a lobby. And upstairs might be paradise.
Oh, I thought they'd just been rooms.
For you and me, baby, paradise.
Oh, you see, I knew I was right and you were wrong. You do want to marry me, don't you?
I don't. What did you say?
I said you do want to marry me, don't you? What did you say?
I didn't say nothing. Whoa, Susanna. Hey, Lanny, I'm back.
Thanks, Will Parker. Promise me you won't die.
Why fight him? I never met the man before. I only fight my friends. Hey, Noanny, honey bunch. How's my sweet little 110 pounds of sugar in the territory?
Oh, wait, this is Annie Hackham.
All right, Hack. Don't mind the way he talks, all right?
I'm going to marry her.
Marry her? How perfect.
No such a thing.
Well, sure. It's a wonderful thing to be married.
Annie!
I got a brother in Persia. He's got 6 wives.
Six wives all at once?
Sure, that's the way to do it in man countries.
Oh, not only. I got another brother in Pudgy. He's only got one wife. He's a bachelor.
Look, Will.
Look, Will, nothing. You know what I got the first prize at the fair? $50.
Oh, $50. That was good.
Can't tell him. Pa promised I'd marry you if I got $50.
That's right, he did.
You know what I've done with it? Spend it all on presents for you.
Oh, but if you spend it, then you ain't got the cash.
Fella who sold me stuff told me it's worth more than cash.
Oh, but Will.
Stop saying, but Will. When do I get you your locus? Oh, wait a minute, honey. You ain't been out of my mind since I left. All the time at the fairgrounds when I was chasing steers, I broke one bubble shot. He landed on the ground. Can't think of you.
Oh, don't start talking, Bernie.
You know a lot of beautiful gals in Kansas City. Didn't you want to look?
Oh, how could you see him if you didn't give him a look?
I mean, I didn't look loving at him like I look at you.
Oh, Will, don't look like that. I can't bear it.
Well, stop looking like this. She'll give me a little old kiss.
Oh, what's a little old kiss?
Well, nothing. Lesson is coming from you.
Oh, you do talk, Bernie. Oh, I won't.
Suppose a man say that your lips are like cherries, your roses are berries, what you gonna do? Can't you feel my heart palpitating and pumping, waiting for something, something nice from you? I gotta get a kiss and it's gotta be quick, girl, jump in a creek and die.
Why should I?
fine fellow.
Oh, don't hide your feelings, Annie. I can't stand him. I bet him come right out and say your heart is busted in two.
Are you positive you'll let him marry Will?
Oh, sure, sure.
And there's no chance you're going to change your mind?
No chance.
All right, then. My heart is busted in two.
Thank you.
special proper. Just one head. It's scandal. It's an outrage. It's a problem we must solve. We gotta start a revolution. All right, boys, revolve.
Don't throw the cake.
jump set. You see what's so elegant about it. Makes girls want to go to parties with them.
As big as all our doors.
Just friendly.
put in the barn, and he treated the rats like equals, which was right.
And he loved little children. He loved everybody and everything in the whole wide world, only he never loved them. So nobody ever noticed.
Straight through without touching. I knowed I could do it. You seen it too, didn't you? Somebody's coming, I expect.
Who fired off the gun? Was that you, Kearney? Don't stand there. You only answer when you're spoken to.
Well, I shot once.
Well, what was you shooting at?
See that knot hole over there?
I see lots of knot holes.
Well, it was one of them.
Well, ain't you a pair of Kearney numbers for picking away knot holes and scaring everybody to death? Somebody ought to give you a good Dutch rub and I'd fill that crate inside of you. It's all right. Nobody hurt. Just a pair of fools swapping noises.
If I visit with you just for a moment, good to get away from the women while you're around. Now, I want to show you a few pretties, private knickknacks, special for the men folk.
I'll see you gentlemen later. I gotta go get a Sarah hired for tonight over at Clarence.
Our post comments.
Who do you think you're taking in that Surrey?
Aunt Ella, of course. And Laura, she'll come with me.
She won't.
Maybe she will.
She promised to go with me, and she better not change her mind. She better not!
Now, I want you to take a look at these straight from patterns.
No, I don't want none of them things now. Say, you got any frog stickers in that bag?
You mean the one that had long knives? What would you want with a thing like that?
Oh, I don't know. Kill a hog or a skunk. It's all the same, ain't it? You know, I'd tell you what I like better than a frog sticker, if you got one. Ever hear of one of them things they call the Little Wonder? It's a thing you hold up to your eyes to see pictures, only that ain't all there is to it, not quite. See, it's got a little jigger onto it. You touch it, and out springs a sharp blade.
And they spring it?
Yeah, you say to a fella, look through here, and when he's looking, you snap out the blade, just above his chest, and bang, down you come.
Good job to play at a friend. A lot of men things like that. Two strangers. What I want to show you is my new stock of postcards.
I'm sick of them things. I want to give me a real woman.
What would you want with a real woman? Why, they're always making trouble, and you say you want one? Why, I'm having a trouble right now on account of a woman. They're always making trouble, and you say you want one? Why, you're a man who is free to come and go as you please. You got a nice, cozy little place, private. No one to bother you. Artistic pictures, they don't talk back to you.
I'm tired of all these pictures of women.
So you're tired of them. Throw them away and buy some new ones. You get tired of a woman, and what can you do? Nothing. You just keep getting tired and tired.
I've made up my mind.
So you want a real woman? Say, do you know a girl by the name of Beta Wanny?
I don't want her.
I don't want her either, but I got her.
Don't want nothing from no peddler. Want real things. What am I doing in here, like that fella says, I'm crawling in a festering? What am I doing in this lousy smokehouse? The floor creaks, the door squeaks, there's a field mouse a nibbling on a broom, and I sat by myself like a cobweb on a shelf, by myself in a lonely
It ain't smelling salt. It's gonna have to make up my mind for me. Watch me take a good whiff now.
Thank you.
Mr. Handsome. I hear you got yourself engaged way to Andy.
Well,
I don't know what to call you. You ain't pretty enough for a skunk. Too skinny to be a man, too small to be a mouse. I reckon you're a rat.
That's logical.
Answer me one question. Do you really love her?
Well,
if I thought you did, I'd tie open that bag and drop you in the river. Are you serious about her?
Yes, I'm serious.
Do you work the ground she walks on like I do? You better say yes.
Yes, yes, yes.
The hell you do.
Yes.
See that bag full of presents? Cost me $50. That's all I have in the world.
But if you had $50 cash.
I have 8 or 80. You loser.
Yes, I loser.
Let's see what you got in the bag.
Might want to buy something.
Well, which one of them?
I'm a vendor, ain't I?
I buy it up.
Maybe pay you real money. Maybe as much as, what a lot. Let's see what we have here. Ah, what a beautiful hot water bag. Looks French. Must have cost plenty.
I'll give you $8.
$8? That wouldn't be honest.
Only pay $3.50.
All right, if I didn't give you $8, then I will. What do we have in here? Oh, see?
That's a cracker, Jake. Take your hands off that.
That was for our wedding night. It don't fit you so good. I'll give you $22 for it.
But that's...
All right, $22.50, not a penny more. Ooh, what do we have here? Oh, what a beautiful ankle brace.
Them knows that was for her to wear.
Don't fit you so good. I'll pay you $15 for it. Let's see. 8 and 22, that's 30, plus 15 is 45, plus 50 cents, that's 45.50.
45.50? Say, that's almost... You want to buy some more?
Mike?
Did you ever see one of these? You put it up dry like this, then you turn a pitch to the right, and then the picture changes.
What made you buy this? Got it in for somebody?
How do you mean? It's just funny pictures.
That's all you think it is?
More than that.
Look. Will, where is everybody? Where is Ann Miller?
They're on the other side of the house. Auction's going on there.
Lori, where's your run to?
So how much give me for this thing?
I don't have no things like that. I guess you don't know what it really is.
It's just a girl in pink tie.
No, it's not pink tie.
She's a fine one out there.
Bill, look up here. I showed
you. Have you two seen Lori?
Sure, just went on the other side of the house. Auction's going on there.
Hey, Chuck, here's one of them things you were looking for. The little one.
Oh, yeah? How much?
$3.50.
That's a lot of money, but I got an idea. It might be worth it. There you go.
Let's see. $3.50 from him and $45 from you. That makes $50, don't it?
Nope. $1 short.
Darn it. Figured wrong. How much you give me for the rest of the stuff in the bag?
$1.
Done. Now I got $50, don't I? You know what that means? It means I'm going to take Ada Wayne back from you.
You wouldn't do a thing like that to me.
Oh, wouldn't I? When I tell a Pa I got most of the money off of, maybe he'll change his mind about who's smart and who's dumb.
Say, fellow, you certainly bungled me.
Nuggets my daughter's hand.
Now wait a minute, that ain't fair.
Going for $50.
And 2 bits.
Why, you stubborn judge? Mr. Cobb is a richer man than you. And I know that I can cut through with that raspberry syrup. Ain't nobody gonna bid anymore?
No, they all dropped out, can't you see?
We got enough, Anna. Let's get on.
Here's the money.
Oh, hold on. You might think I'm going gone yet.
We'll see it.
What'd you say was getting, Laurie?
Just five.
And for how much?
It's a quarter.
I don't think that's quite enough. Do you?
What do you got?
Got a saddle here. Cost me $30.
You can't bid saddles. It's got to be cash.
$30 saddle got to be worth something to somebody, don't it?
Don't be a fool, boy. You can't earn a living without that saddle. I'll give you 10.
You got money?
Right in your pocket.
Sold. Don't let's waste time. How high you going?
I'm you, no matter what.
Aunt Ella, I'm bidding all this $10 Todd just gave me.
$10? Going?
And 2 bits.
Hurry.
Most of you boys know my horse, Blue. She's a kind of nice horse, generally well broke.
Well, don't go, Blue. It ain't worth it.
I'll give you 25 for her.
Sold. That makes my bid $35, Aunt Ella.
Hurry, you're crazy.
You just put up everything you got in the world, didn't you? Can't fit the clothes off your back because they ain't worth nothing. Can't fit your gun because you need that. Yes, sir, you need that bad. So, Anna, I'm just as reckless as Curly McLean, I guess. Just as good at getting what I want. Gonna bid all I got in the world. All I saved for 2 years doing farm work. All for the Lord. Here it is. $42.31.
Anybody want to buy a gun? Bought a brand new last Thanksgiving, worth a lot.
Oh, please don't buy a gun.
Give me $18 for it.
So, that makes my bid $53 an hour. Anybody going any higher?
Go, go, go! What's the matter with you folks? Ain't nobody gonna cheer or nothing?
Thank you.
y'all can never imagine. But before I give up any more, I want to know your intentions.
Please, you say it.
Said you saved. Brought it on yourself. Can't help it. Can't never rest. Told you the way it was. You wouldn't listen.
Oh,
say goodbye here, baby.
Oh, can't even stay to drink the coffee,
Lauren. Time for the lonely gypsy to go back to the open road.
Well, I wish I was going. Then you wouldn't be so lonely.
Look, ain't no any. There's a man I know who loves you like nobody ever loved nobody.
Oh, yeah, Mary, how can
a man who will stick to you all your life, and that's the man for you, Will Parker.
Oh, well, I like Will a lot.
He's a fine fellow. Strong like an ox, young and handsome.
Oh, I love him all right. I did.
Of course you do. You love those clear blue eyes of his and the way his mouth wrinkles up when he smiles.
Do you love him too?
I love him because he would make my Ada Annie happy.
Oh, that's
dirty. I'll say good. Wait, I'll show you how we say goodbye in Persia.
Goodbye?
We have an old song we sing in Persia. One goodbye is never enough. I'm glad you will marry such a wonderful man as Will Parker. You deserve a fine fellow, and you've got one.
No, Will. I will help you. Goodbye.
I will. I wanted to say goodbye to you, too.
Oh, no, you don't. I just saw the last one.
You were made for each other. Be good to her, Will, and you be good to him. If you don't mind, I'm friend of the family.
Did you say you were going?
Yes, yes, time for the lonely gypsy to go back to the open road. But first, I'll show you how we say goodbye to my country. Lucky fellow. Wished it was me she was marrying instead of you.
Don't seem to make no difference, hardly.
Time for the lonely gypsy to go back to the open road. One goodbye is never enough.
You ain't gonna think of that fellow man no matter, are you? I'm never gonna leave your side.
Oh, even if you never go away on a trip or nothing, can't you once in a while give me one of them Persian goodbyes?
Persian goodbye? That ain't nothing compared to no going below.
Oh. Hello, Lee.
Yeah. worry, Bubbles.
We need to be rude, didn't we?
Grandma.
Think about this time, we ain't got no need for women.
Yeah.
For this time, the women ain't got no need for men.
Oh, no.
Who wants to be dead?
Dave Tyler, till the morning.
Is he alive?
the judge.
What? You saw the judge, ain't you?
Well, yes, lawyers.
Well, no, get over it.
Wouldn't be proper. You gotta do it in court.
Oh, fiddlesticks, let's do it here and state it in court.
You can't do that. That's breaking the law.
Well, let's not break the law.
No.
Let's defend a little. Come on, Andrew, start the trial. We ain't got a few minutes.
Andrew, I got a attack.
Oh, shut up. Making him the boy a fair trial without knocking him up on his wedding night. Now, here's the long and short of it. First, I got to ask you, what's your plea?
Well, that means,
why did you do it? Oh, why did I do it? Yes, because he'd been pestering Laurie and I don't want to see it.
Just a minute.
Don't let your tongue wander around in your mouth like that. Just listen to my question. What happened tonight that made you kill him?
Well, he came to me with a knife.
Yes, and you had to defend yourself, didn't you?
Oh, why, yes, and furthermore,
no, never mind the furthermores. The plea is self-defense.
Yes, it's about time, Andy.
Quiet! Now, was there a witness tonight we saw this happen?
Well, everybody saw it, Andrew. You were there. You saw it tonight.
Feel funny about it. Feel funny.
Oh, you'll feel funny when I tell you why. You carry off another woman, won't you?
Who's she on you?
I ain't carrying on with no one.
Maybe not, but you'll sure feel funny when I tell you why you are.
That's all you like, but it's federal marshal, I.
Oh, shut up about being a federal marshal. We're not going to let you out of the boil this wedding night, because we're just not going to. So shut up.
Keep going, but let's just take that to the jury if you're like,
sir. Hey, wait! I ain't even told the verdict yet.
Well, the verdict's not guilty, ain't it?
Well, of course.
Well, say it.
All right.
Not guilty!
Court adjourned!
Hey, old Danny, where on earth have you been?
Oh, well, we had a little misunderstanding, but he explained it to me fine.
Hey there, friend.